Hey you guys, what's going on? So I decided to do something a little different. Well, I've done tags before, but not quite like this. And it's, why are you on this dreadlock journey? And I'm put the link down below to the one that I watched, so I'm subscribed to him. And I said, hey, I wanted to do this. So I started this journey. It's over a year now. Yes, over a year. And I don't want to sound cliche and say, oh, it's a spiritual journey, but it actually turns out it sort of is. You know, when you think of spiritual, it's not automatically, oh, church and all this blah, 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 blah stuff. Now, I had locks years ago, my whole head. I had locks. And it wasn't, to me, it was just a hairstyle. Then, you know, I want locks, you know, no purpose behind it, just it's a hairstyle, something to do. As you can see, you know, those who watched me for a while, you know, that didn't last long because my hair would be, yo, probably down to my bottom by now. But, So here we are in 2017 and, I have hair on my head. I have over 30 something locks. Yeah, a little bit over 30. I started counting them and I stopped at 30. I was like, yeah, whatever, it's over 30. Just trying to get some information to give y'all. But anyway, why am I on this dreadlock journey? I said for year, you know, before 2000, before 2016. What actually the date that I started? I'll tell you. So, yeah, I started 2016. Wow, time flies. And, you know, before I started, you know, I always tell my brother, I'm gonna lock my hair. He's like, yeah, whatever. Because anyone who knows me, I don't like hair on my head. I don't. For years, again, I've been wearing the Caesar, I guess it's called, and I just like the fact that I can just get up and go bathe and shower and just go and don't have to worry about my hair. I don't like beauticians. I'm not sitting in some place for hours. And too much attention is focused on your hair. Now, although I liked it neat, but I'm not putting all that in for what? Yeah. Go to hairdressers. I remember growing up, I used to go to hairdressers like every, I don't got time for that. Used to prep. Yeah, when I was able to do my own hair, make my own decisions. Oh, what freedom. Anyway, so here we are, 2017, and I said, you know what? I'm ready to do this. And I was looking at processes on how to begin it and da-da-da. And talking to people that I know that have locks, I finally decided I'll start with the sponge method. And here we are. It has taught me patience. Anyone who knows me, patience is not, I have very little. For stuff that doesn't profit, you know, it's not serving me. I don't have the patience. And this has taught me how to wait. It's taught me when I'm frustrated not to just give up because the outcome is lovely. I mean, I look at my hair sometimes and I'm like, wow. I keep saying, I have hair in my head. I mean, sometimes I'm like this because this hair touching my scalp. It's taught me that in order to get to a result, there's going to be some unpretty times. Because sometimes my hair does some things and I'm like, I just want to cut this off. But then the next day I'm like, wow, I just love it. So it's teaching me how to wait. Wait. And I can foresee how, you know, this style that I want to do. No, I'm not doing no bantu knots on my head. Someone said that in one of my blogs. I was like, stop. I can see myself doing, you know, once it grows, that, you know, the pineapple, you know, it's the, yeah. I mean, those who follow me on Instagram see, like, when I go to court, I cut my hair to size. I put them in ponytail because it's easier and I don't want to, you know, by mistake cut off one of the hairs. I'm looking forward to what this journey brings me. Sometimes I feel like, oh my God, my hair looks a mess. You know, I'm glad I don't work in the corporate arena because I don't know how it'd be then. You know, there's a lot of flack and stuff like that. You know, again, I like my hair neat and it's like, oh, Jesus. It's teaching me that everything is not necessarily going to go how I want it to, but the end result is going to make me happy. So, again, would I say spiritual? Yes, because it's teaching me how to apply that to other areas in my life. Because Lord have mercy. Yes, It's teaching me patience, but patience for those things that are going to serve me.
Yeah.
So I hope you enjoyed this, and if you have any questions, put it down below, and I'll be sure to answer them, maybe in another tag or just down below. Anyway, guys, yeah. Watch me as I continue on this journey, and I'm out, y'all.